Okay. Okay, here we are. New location and everything. Can't interact with you. Not you. That seems like the end goal. Let's start simple. So we go up here. What happens when I press this? Yes. Doing a mini gauntlet, are we? Okay. Okay, yep, definitely mini gauntlet. And you. Any more? Oh, I see what's going on. Means it's going to be this side next. Okay. You got to kill them all. Means we need do that. Means I've got to do one more wave, well, probably two more. Come on. Oh. be here. No. Oh, that was close. This side? Yep. That'll do. Crap. Crap. Oh, that's that boss. Try throwing you over here. Over here. Come on. Okay. Normally this side. Yeah. Should be this side. Yeah. Okay, I've killed them all. See? One blue. Oh, damn you. Oh. This one. There we go. Okay, that's what we're dealing with here. Whoa. I saw that happening. Okay. Combat challenge. Ow. Oh, little victory shoot, huh? Okay. Okay, we've got to deal with the shooters as soon as they turn up. It's the only thing that makes sense. We can do this. Okay. Come on. Best strategy I've got at the moment. Come on. God darn, that was hard. Appears we're going up. Wow. Whoa! Now where the heck are we?
Quill felt a swell of pride as she approached the cavern river. Its guiding banks once led her people to safety after the Cinder Night. Now, all these years later, she would follow it back.
I get a feeling this is an end of a chapter. Yeah. Really enjoy this game. Oh. Okay, we found a castle. Move on. Stones. Bright light.
Quill's muscles ached and her eyes grew heavy. She decided it best to set up camp and rest before journeying on to the castle.
Hey, kid. Good. You're alive.
The starling spoke as it circled the campfire.
That it?
Quill gasped in shock as the starling unveiled monstrous wings and curled horns. It descended, talons gleaming.
Oh dear, I didn't mean to scare you.
I'm not scared, Quill replied. I just didn't know starlings were feathered.
This starling thing's gotta go, kid. The name's Adurin. No, we aren't feathered. Only me. I'm working on it. Let's just say choosing the wrong friends comes with a price. But you seem like a good friend to have.
Thanks, I think. Quill readied her meal and paused to take in the strange winged creature who now called her friend. As a field of stars bloomed over the sky, their campfire conversations deepened.
He's all I have. If I lose him, I don't know what I'll do, confided Quill.
Adurin looked down at his wings.
If I help you find him, can you help me? If we can,
we will, Starling. I mean, Adurin. Although Quill was far from the safety and comfort of her nook in the cottage, her exhaustion led her into a deep sleep.
Hey, Ghostface. A lot of folks have been waiting for a reader like you to return. I know I have. I'm going to scout the castle up ahead. Keep her safe, okay? For both our sakes.